Hello students, today we are going to read an interesting story named Into the Wild, written by Kiran Purandure. As the name suggests, the write-up is an amazing experience of the writer where the lone traveler is completely lost in the jungle of Umbarzara. He narrates how he lost his way at the fall of the dusk and the terrifying turmoil he underwent thereafter. He also gives us a detailed description of how he found his way towards the Pitezari. Let's start. The 8.5 hour long day inside the height was as fruitful as the jamba tree standing tall on the edge of Umbarzara. Now here the writer, Kiran Purandure, is a bird watcher and he is also a wildlife expert. So here he has used the jamba tree as a place to watch the bird. And the word hide here means a place built to look like its surrounding so that birds does not come to know that who is there, so they don't fly away. So here the writer has used the jamba tree in the place named Umbarzara as a place to stand there and watch the bird. Before wrapping up my day at this natural water hole. Now here, after this 8.5 hour long day watching the birds, now he is wrapping to go to his place back. I took entries of avifauna in my field notes. He took entries of avifauna. Avifauna here means birds of a particular region, habitat or geological period. Whatever he has watched throughout this 8.5 hour long day, he is making notes of that. He made entries of that. Since I was alone, I rushed to Pitezari village where I was stationed. Means he was alone there in Umbarzara. And now he is hurrying up to go back to the village named Pitezari where he is staying. I camouflaged the height. Here, camouflaged means to disguise by covering it to make it blend with its surrounding. Means just to cover so that the birds or animal doesn't notice it. Took my essentials, came out of the height. Means he took all his essential thing, means it must be the notebook, camera, water bottle, tiffin box, whatever things he has taken along with him, all those he is taking out from the hide and now he is moving. Came out of the hide and stretched out to my heart's content. Means it was a small place where he was stationed, he was waiting there to watch the birds. So now when he is coming from that place out, he stretched out his body to its heart content. I lifted my camera bag and took the familiar trail to Pitezari. Means familiar way to the village Pitezari. He took his camera bag and he is on his way to the village. Negotiating the webbed leaves of teak wood and moha trees. Means he is very minutely watching the webbed leaves of teak wood and moha trees, trying to make minimal sound as the leaves which are on the ground there, they must be dried. So if the writer walks on those leaves, their dried leaves, it will make sound. So he is walking very slowly so that the sound could not be heard by the animals as he is in the jungle alone here. I was trading cautiously among the woods. Means he is walking very in a very alert way among the woods because he doesn't want to be noticed by the wild animals there as he is alone in the jungle. Walking alone in a jungle needs more alertness than walking with a companion. As he is alone in the jungle, so he need to be more alert here. I was alone here like a fox. Means how in a jungle fox is alone here. When fox is there, all the other animals and all, they run away. So in the same way he is saying that I am also alone here in the jungle. Following trail silently means following the trail, my way silently. Watching with wide open eyes, my ears were grasping a variety of sound just when a familiar sound stunned me. Means he was very much alert. He was walking very silently so that the dried leaves doesn't make any sound. Or his eyes were wide open so that he was continuously looking here and there. And he was very keenly, he was looking here and there, and he was trying to hear also if any sound of any animal he could hear. Then suddenly he hears a sound. It was a familiar sound, like kyak, kyak, kyak. It was a langur alarm call, and the sound was of langur. You can say it is a animal like monkey. The leader of the gang of langur was sitting on the tall tree making alarm calls out of fear for life. Means this langur and the gang of langur, they were making alarm call. Rest of the langur brigade continued raising the alarm calls, and the other langurs were also making alarm calls for the fear of life. The network of alarm call was expanding its range as the petrified langurs speeded to the trees near and far and secured their places on treetops. Means the alarm, the sound of those alarm was rising high and high because these langurs were petrified. They were very frightened. Means they were feared that some, you can say, animal is coming here, wild animal is coming here, it might eat them up. So that's why they wanted to go to their treetops so that they are secured. All this upheaval was created by only one animal's presence, a leopard. Now, this upheaval here means sudden violent upset or disruption here. Means all were, these langurs were making sound, alarm sound, and they were trying to run on the treetops, climb on the treetops here. So, all this was only because of one animal, and it was a leopard. Many animals make alarm calls when they see a predator. A predator here means an animal that hunts or kills other organisms. So here when they see any predator coming, like tiger or leopard nearby, if it is coming, so they just run away to secure place. Same the langurs were doing. The langur is most reliable when it comes to finding clues about the presence of the apex predators. Means apex means topmost predators in the jungle. If they see, it was a reliable source from which other animals come to know if the tiger or leopard, they are coming here. The mighty elusive leopard of Umbarzara was out of its lair. Means this mighty elusive leopard of Umbarzara, he was out of his lair, means out of his den or secret place. So other the langurs were running to the climbing the treetops to secure themselves. He was on the prowl. Prowl means he was on the search for his prey. He was in search of the animal which he can catch and eat. He was on the prowl. The stealthily moving figure spotted gold black cloak was spied by this langur. Stealthily means act in such a way that actions are unnoticed. Means it was moving in such a way that other animals doesn't know and it can just go and catch them. Was spied by this langur. Spied means what? These langurs were also very clever. They very secretly watched that this leopard is coming. So they all climb the treetops to secure themselves. Even the small ones from the legion of langurs were giving alarm calls. Chuck, chuck. I stayed put, gorged the leader. Gorged the leader langur's target sight and scanned the area visually. Means he just stopped there when he watched all this thing going on. The writer just stopped there, gorged the leader langur's target sight and scanned the area visually. Means he was looking all around to see if the leopard was there. took some steps. He took some more step, moved forward, stopped again. A fresh scat was lying before me on the trail. Scat here means animals dropping. It was very fresh, by which the writer understood that the animal is nearby only. The bluish purple fly is hovering over it. When the dropping of that animal, which was fresh and lying on the ground there, on the way there, so the writer also saw that the bluish purple flies were hovering, means they're lingering or moving over it, flying over it. I was sure that the leopard was somewhere here, means because of this dropping here and it was fresh, so here the writer realized, or he came to know that the leopard was somewhere nearby. The distant alarm call of four horned antelope was adding to the cause, and the antelope was also making alarm call. I barely walked around 15 meters and stopped. The writer again started walking, and he just walked for 15 meters and then again he stopped. I had apparently entered into the sanctum sanctorum. Sanctum sanctorum here means the holy of holies, a place, region where few are allowed, as the secret important work is done there. He reached this place of a miracle called leopard, means where the leopard used to stay. The writer went there only. The big cat was not visible, but for it was luck of the writer that at that time the big cat, means the leopard, was not there. It is an elusive animal. Means here the writer is saying elusive animal means what? The animal which just go and you can say catches the other animal and eats them up. The surrounding were reminding me that I was all alone time and again. And the surrounding, as no one was there, because all the animals knew it was the place of leopard. So no one was there and writer was all alone, so he was now scared. As I moved forward on the trail to Pitezari, the fading alarm calls were still heard in the background. Means as he was moving forward there, taking steps forward, the sound was becoming, you can say, less as he was taking steps forward. I could tell instinctively that the leopard had moved away. Means he's saying, I could tell instinctively means without cautious thought, by natural response, that the leopard has moved away from this place. Meanwhile, I saw a man standing at a distance with a stick in his hand. And suddenly he sees a man standing with a stick in his hand. As I approached, he appeared, spooked due to the alarm calls of the leopard. Means as the writer approached, means as he went near him, he appeared spooked here, means you can say frightened due to the alarm calls of the leopard here. We greeted each other, means he's saying we are both of them, the man and the writer, they both greeted each other. He was Raju Escape from Pitezari. He had come to collect logs but retreated due to the leopard's movement. Means this person has also come to collect the woods from the jungle, but due to leopard's movement, he is not moving, or he is not going into jungle, he is going back to his village. Raju was amazed at my regular solitary visits to Umbarzara. Means when they have a conversation, writer tells him that he regularly comes here to watch the birds, as he is a bird watcher. So the man, Raju Escape, he was surprised to know this, that he every day comes alone here. The haven for tigers here means the place for the tigers where they usually stay there, or they are always found there. Tigers, leopards, sloth bears and all. We stopped under a kusum tree to take a break. Both of them now stopped at one tree named kusum. We both felt a bit relaxed. Now first both were alone on different path there, but now as they both were together, so they felt relaxed. Now we were four eyes, four hands with a stick. Then we both resumed our walking tour. And after taking some rest, they again started to walk to the village. There was one tiny track that broke out of the main trail. Means there was a track. From that track, main track, other route was also there. I will take this route, you go straight, said Raju and turned right. Means Raju said that I am going to take this route, the other route, you go straight. I kept walking. Now the writer is alone again here. I kept walking straight until I climbed a familiar hillock. Means he was walking straight until he came near a hillock. It was very familiar as he used to come here regularly. I crossed the cement pillar and stones stacked by the Forest Development Corporation to mark the boundary of the forest compartment. Took another trail. After climbing down, means he came down from there and he took another trail. Walked across a beautiful mahua tree loaded with reddish brown leaves. The ground under the tree was cleaned very well. The thought instantly flashed in my mind, I had lost my way. Means the ground was completely clean. So he realized that I have lost my way, I am going in the wrong direction. Next moment I found another dusky trail. Means dusky means a dark place there. You can say it was not, there was no light there. Hastily, I took the trail which took me from a narrow gorge to an open field. Means very hurriedly, he took that trail which took him to a narrow gorge. Gorge here means a narrow gully between hillocks. He took from that gorge, he went to an open field. The area was surrounded by hillocks of dry deciduous tropical forest. Means that open field was there and it was surrounded by deciduous forest. Deciduous tropical trees, you can say here. I turned back to spot the sun. Means he was looking for sunlight. Now the geographical west was set. Means it was becoming dark. The sun was setting. The dusky trail had vanished. Means that dark area from where he came, it has vanished. It was not to be seen. Good heavens, I was lost. Means suddenly he realized that he has lost his way. Now he is not able to find from where he had come. Completely lost in this jungle. That too at a very dreadful time. The sun was melting down like a fleeting runner. Fleeting runner here means the runner who is passing very quickly. In the same way, it was becoming dark. Soaked in my own sweat. Now as he was very frightened, so he was soaked in his own sweat. I felt like shouting to my heart's content. Means to the fullest level of satisfaction, he wanted to shout now. But there was no other soul to listen to my sound in this wilderness. Means but there was no one there to listen to him. I had two bags with me. The Shabnam bag having the camera and on the other was small colorful handmade bag used in villages to carry tiffin. Means he had two things, a bag which in which camera was there and other one bag was in which he carried the tiffin. The tiffin still had some stuff but I didn't feel like having it. Means in the tiffin some food was there but still he didn't feel like eating it because he was very scared and he wanted to just reach the village. The blossoming boxwood trees, the boop boop sound of cockle bird, the song of robin bird all appeared alien to me. Means it was very, you can say, alien means new. He didn't understand that where he was there. It was more than an hour. I was still there searching for a suitable tree to climb and get secured. Means he realized that now he's all alone and it is night time. So if he want to save his life, he has to just climb the tree and wait there till the sun rises. Turn back to the trail you left, my mind was telling me. Means a thought came into his mind just to go back from the way he had come. But there were no signs of the trail. I had no other way to climb the hillock before me. Means, but there were no signs. Means, he had lost his way. So he is saying here, he had no other way to climb the hillock. There were more hillocks and some more around the one I was standing. Means there were so many hillocks here, they were where he was standing. Near my feet were the dried up droppings of sloth bear. Means where he was standing, he saw dried droppings of sloth bear. The sloth bear of Umbar Zara must be out in open sniffing for food. Then he realized, as the droppings were there, he realized this sloth bear must be nearby only and it must be sniffing for food. I cautioned myself. Means he just made himself alert, thinking of averting of all sorts of eventuality. Means he thought that he should turn away and just save himself from the possible event or the possible incident that might happen if he doesn't go back. I made a move. I ran down the hillock that I had climbed up at a frantic speed. Means he just ran down the hillock and he climbed up at a frantic speed. Means in a hurried and excitingly excited, as he was very scared. The west was to my right side now. The evening breeze flew through my wet curled hair and my stomach was aching. I kept walking in hope. After around 50 steps, I found a bright red soil trail. Means after around 50 steps, he found bright red soil trail away there. I found my silver lining on this trail. Silver lining here means a good aspect of mostly bad event. Means he found a hope there that it is a red soil, means some habitation people must be living there. There were marks of bicycle wheel on this trail. That was a big consolation for me. Means he really felt relaxed now. There must be a village nearby. I reassured myself. More questions resurfaced. How far is the village and where and in which direction? Means all these questions came into his mind. I climbed one more hillock and tried to locate signs of human civilization. Means he climbed the hillock and from the top he wanted to see where there was human civilization. My legs were trembling as he was continuously walking. He was scared, his stomach was aching. Because of all that, his legs were trembling, means shaking. As I reached the top of the hill, he was trembling, I mean, he was very scared here. As I reached the top of the hill, I jumped with joy. Means suddenly he saw something there, so he jumped with joy. He heard the sounds of people talking in loudspeaker. In a jiffy, means in a very hurried way, I ran down the hill towards the sound with full vigor, means full strength. I stumbled and fell down, means as he was running very fast, so he stumbled and fell down. Saw droppings of blueberry nearby, struggled, stood up and decided which direction to move on. And he again came down and he decided in which direction to move so that he can go to that village there. The signs of civilization were visible, means now he could see the people there. The tiny sleepy village of Pitezari was visible through the green woods. Means he could see the village from the trees there. The lantern of Raji Ram Bhalavi's farm, the loudspeaker installed for Keshav Bhalavi's marriage, all were in clear sight. Now he came near the village. Turned left to spot the village lake and familiar hillock Sui Hudaki. The dog barked to welcome me to the village. Now he finally reached the village. The first thing I did was to take a bath. The shaking of limb was lessened a bit, means as because he was very scared, he had walked a lot, so his legs were trembling now, but now it has lessened a bit. The stomach ache started again. So and then he ate to the full and then slumped onto the cot. Slumped means fell heavily. He was very tired. Lying awake, looking at the star-studded sky, I spoke to myself, there still exists a jungle where we can get lost. Isn't this our good luck? Now then he is thinking, is lying in a very relaxed way. He is watching the looking he is looking at the stars in the sky, and he is thinking that there's still a jungle, a thick jungle where a person can get lost. So we should, this is our good luck. Now, because of this continuously cutting down of trees and all for habitation, we feel that there are no more forests, no more trees are all around. But here the writer is saying we are still lucky that there are thick forests still there. I hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.